Well, hello all you people. Welcome back to the Bison Workshop. I'm Bob. And we have been forced into a job I did not want to do. I got a 84 F350 that looks to me like it was turned into a F7 or 800, and it's pretty beefy, and I was only doing parking brake cables, and I was having a hard time getting that started because sizes just vary. So I'm gonna have to change a design on that frame. So I'm just gonna have to cut them rivets off, knock them pins out, and move that bracket forward. Or actually, I think I have a better idea. I think I'm gonna make a new bracket that's longer than, let me get this and I'll show you what I'm talking about. This here is where your cable comes in from the pedal. So the pedal's here. Your right and your left is hooked in here, and then this is spring loaded. Alright, well, I'm going to be lacking about 2 inches of making it to this. So I'm probably going to have to make one of these that is wider. So I'm going to try to find something that's wider than this and then just drill the holes and then slot them just like that. So, and I think that would be the more feasible way of going. So, I think I have some wide enough square to do that somewhere here, we hope. Anyway, but I wanted to show you guys some of the stuff that had happened and what caused me to go in this direction. Trust me, I was not looking forward to this. Now remember, I've had the truck about 2 years and have, well, about 2.5 years, 3 years at the most. And ever since then, I had had moved here and ended up all hell breaking loose in my life. So, you know, I'm trying to fix this truck as I was changing things in life. When I was going to put the parking brake cables in it, I had to take the wheels off to get in there and take the parking brake cable out. Well, that led into another problem. On the passenger side, this seal was in it and it was leaking and pretty much saturated everything with all that nasty grease. And the other side was a little drier, rusty looking color, so we're going to change that. We hope we can get that far enough apart that I can clean all them pieces up and repaint every piece. But, you know, some of the hardware was rusted, and I can't understand why one side, well, no, I do understand. It just clicked. This side was greasy, so this side looks, all the pieces, once you clean them up, looks exactly like they did when I bought them 2 years ago. Like that. But the one that came out of the driver's side looked like that. Look at the difference. So, you know, all these pieces are going to get painted. I ordered new hardware for it. I'm getting tired of having brake problems with this truck. I've had brake problems from the get-go with this truck. And, you know, I've went through three master cylinders in a row. I've had to rebuild the clutch system, put a new flywheel in it, in some stranger's front yard. Before I ended up here. That was a dull moment anyway. Anyway, let's get back to task here. I cleaned these up and I just laid them in here. But I think they're a little too tight a fit in this direction. I just got them in there backwards. But I took, cleaned those up. Now, I'm going to see if I got a tap. I would like to run a tap down on these, or a die. Simply because they were pretty rough. I can't afford any lug nuts, but you know, these are the big long ones. It's got the, let's see here. Yeah, it got 2.5 inch studs, so this truck will take a dually. I could turn this truck into a dually if I want to. And if I could afford aluminum wheels for a dually and the fender flares, yes indeed I'd have me a full dually. This would be a badass truck. But I don't know, the extra wheel might not help you in a situation where you was in snow. Yeah, you got more tires, but the truck will move different. It'll be stiffer. So stiff's not always good in snow. You want to be able to glide across it evenly so that it distributes weight evenly. So, you know, when you start stiffening trucks, and this thing's got 12 leaves in the rear on each side. Somebody looks to me like they took about 3 or 4 sets and made one. So, yeah, I wouldn't have done that shabby of a job on them springs. The driver's or the passenger side's not too bad, but they didn't do the same on the driver's side as they did on the passenger side. On the driver's side, there's no guide to keep all them springs in a row. So, the other side has the guides. But in order for me to put those guides on it, I would have to, let me think that through here. I might be able to drill a hole in it and be able to separate them far enough that I can tap it out and thread it. I could bolt a bracket on it and it would thread into the one spring where the other one would be. Yeah, I'm gonna fix that. But if I do that, I gotta do the same on the other side. Anyway, we got these painted up nice and pretty. I got it still clean the inside of them out. I wanted to leave most of the grease in there so that I didn't have to worry about masking this off. I could just spray it, and then once I'm done, once I wipe that grease out of there, paint will go with it. And then this part here will be it'll be cleaned up with a probably just run my grinder around it with the sander wheel, or even one of these cookies would work, you know, to go around here and make it a nice pretty machined surface. And I don't think there's anything else that needs to be a machined surface. That does need to be filed a little bit, But I had to clean, when I cleaned it up, man, I'm telling you, I had to take the chipping hammer, right there it is, and knock the rust out of in between those, and I think that turned out pretty nice, you know. And it still looks rugged now. And then this will go on here. Now this is painted with heat, high temperature paint, flat high temperature paint. And I'm probably going to go over it one more coat. That's the steam that I want to go with on my truck. Gloss and flat. Gloss trim, flat surfaces. So I think these two will marry each other very nicely. So, and I ain't got no blocks or anything. Well, maybe I do. Let me try one of these out and see how it looks. The way it's supposed to be in there. Well, that one's not big enough. Maybe I can do it that way. Alright. Let's see how this bad boy looks. I gotta clean the rear end, or the rear axles up. Because, believe it or not, they got built up of rust on the inside of them. So, that tells me there's water getting in there somewhere. I masked off the inside where the brakes are going to set, and then once I've got this tape off, I'm going to take my sandpaper, probably 180, and I'm going to sand it evenly. By God, I think it looks pretty good. So now I gotta do something about these. I gotta clean them up. And I'm debating on what paint I wanna use, or what I wanna use. There's not really a whole lot you can do except to keep these oiled. If you paint them, the first time you put a socket on it, it cuts right through the paint and rips it. And then you got to touch it up. One of these days I'm going to figure out a way to do this. Where it'll look like it's natural metal. But I like to tap these studs. I'd actually rather have a new set than a new set of lug nuts, but that ain't gonna happen, not for a long time. And while we're at it, I'm gonna go ahead and take the, let me put you all up here. I'm gonna clean all these pieces up and repaint them. All these are gonna be gloss, black. This will be gloss black. The thread's nice and pretty, greased on the tips, and then you got your wheel cylinder. Now see, these wheel cylinders are both exactly the same age, but you look at the difference from one wheel to the other of the environment. This one here is so, it looks like it's 40 years old. And in actuality, check this out. This will prove to you that I just did these brakes and put new hardware kit on it 2 years ago. Alright. Does that look like a brand new pin to you? The wheel cylinders look entirely different. The wheel cylinder on the greasy side was nice and pretty. And what saved it was the oil leak. So I've got these separated because I wanted to go exactly back on the side that they're supposed to be. This here is passenger side, this here is driver's side. And we're going to take the rear end apart. We're going to take the back plate off. I'm down this far. I've got the axles out of it. Might as well take another 12 bolts out, clean it out, put some new sealing on it, get everything nice and working right and painted. I'm going to take the bed off of it before I do any painting. I've done a little bit of painting on the sides where it's going to be between the wheels where I can't get to it. But it's all going to be brushed paint. I'm going to brush on exterior semi-gloss black. And we're going to do it with a brush. And after I brush it, I'm going to take a little roller and just go over every last bit of it. And that'll give you that texture look. So I don't like brush marks. So I always like to come in behind it before it gets all dry. And just rake it all out with a roller. So I'm not sure I'm going to like this heat paint because it looks like it takes oil really quickly. And it changes the looks of it. It's not flat anymore right here. That's why I got to recoat it. So I don't know what happened there. Let me see if that'll wipe off. This is a clean towel here. Yeah, it wiped off. And so once we get the rear end back together and sealed, and I got to check the vent tube on it too, because rear end's got to have circulation. Got a lot of speeding parts in there. It's got to have some place to breathe. So, you know, anywhere there's air can come in, water can come in too. So you got to make sure that the water don't come in with the air. And it's kind of impossible because if you got a vent on it, it's breathing either way. Moisture can go anywhere. So you just control it. So after I take the bed off of it, we'll just clean it up and paint it. Take the shocks off. While I've got it that far, might as well go ahead and put the bushings in it. I got the bushing kit for the springs. I already found something else that needs to be fixed on that truck today. I was looking. See, I got 37-inch tires on that truck. And that's bigger than I wanted. I wanted 35s. And the problem is I can't find a cheap set of 35 1250s to go all the way around it. Simply because only one company actually makes it. And there's a waiting list. And by the time you get done with your waiting list, you might as well went ahead and got the cheap stuff. Because you're going to be setting a while. And I had to put these 37s on there. And it killed me to have to do that. And I knew what that was going to cause. But so I was looking to see why the front tar kept hitting in one spot on that chrome piece that goes around my fender. And it's bending it and it's pissing me off. So I was looking underneath there, and it looks to me like the body has fell. So, the front radiator support where it mounts to the frame, the whole bottom square needs to be rebuilt. Needs new metal put in it and new braces. And it wouldn't take much to weld a couple new panels in it. And you can do it in a way where it would really look good too and reinforce it at the same time. So that's what's going to happen. I'm going to have to duplicate that whole bottom and replace that whole plate and just make a cap to put on it and weld it in place. Sort of like the old 70s model cab mounts. Anyway, I got a lot of stuff to do to that truck. So I'm debating on whether to add an inch to the body, to the frame. Either that or I'm going to have to take that chrome piece off until I can get me a set of 35s. 35 is the perfect tar for that truck. It'd be cool if you was to take and paint that flat black. You could do it flat black and then paint tagger stripes in the gloss, or you can reverse it, either way. I'm going to have to try that out. That's going to be a video. how to make tagger stripes with black, flat, and gloss. Let's see what that looks like. I bet that would be cool as shit. I think that'd look pretty cool, do some tagger stripe like that. The motor's tagger stripe with chrome. I got the motor blue, and I got chrome or aluminum tape on it for chrome tagger stripes. And I think that would look pretty cool to take the drums and do the same thing to the drums. But I don't think you see enough of the drum for it to be feasible. Yeah, I would know it was there, but that ain't showing at all. So we'll just have to see what it looks like with the wheel. And if you can't see it very good, there's really no point in doing the drum. Because if you're not going to see it anyway, I just got little round holes all the way around my wheel, so probably wouldn't be able to see it very good. But the rear end cover, that's a whole different story. And I can do the shocks in the blue, the same color as the motor, and put the silver tagger stripes on the shocks. That'd be cool. Got a long way to go with this truck. And it just depends on what life throws at me, that what gets done. So I'm going to cut this short and we'll talk at you later.